What's some juicy gossip you just found out in your personal lives? One cousin's wife finally caught his cheating ass. 3 years he's been playing her for a fool, but she actually knew. She just loves him too much. Two, heard that the asshole who got fired because of the email that I sent to the company's VP. Honestly wish I went with filing for a labor case though. 3, apparently, I'm adopted. Not really sure if the ancestry thing works. I want to find my biological parents. So much stuff is happening. I don't even know anymore, lol. My sister is pregnant with her third child. Third guy. The first father, V, is awesome. He has custody of both their child and her second. No biological relationship to him. The second baby daddy has apparently been threatening my sister and V after learning of the third child and that V took her in. V and my sister still have a functional platonic relationship at this point, and due to fear of reproach from the second, and maybe the third, V has taken both kids, my pregnant sister, and his own so with him out of state to make sure there's no reproach from 2 or 3. V is one of my favorite humans. He treats the second child like his own, despite no longer being in a romantic relationship with my sister, since 2010. Dude is as good as they come, in my opinion. That my brother asked my mom for a $1,000 for rent. She gave him $1,400 so he could also pay back a loan. Then he turned around and also asked my dad for $1,000 for rent, which he also gave him. He then turned around and used the money to buy tickets to Burning Man. My parents aren't going to lend out any more money without talking to each other first. I just found out that one of my work colleagues who just returned from a 2-week expensive holiday with his wife in Iceland has just found out his wife has run up about £50,000 debt on numerous credit cards. One of the girls in our group of friends has never really gotten over her ex that left her 3 years ago. She will often bring him up when drunk and it has really hampered her dating life. He lives thousands of miles away, and today he posted a picture of him sitting with an attractive dude getting coffee. They are holding hands and their legs are touching. We were all sitting around the TV hanging out when she saw the picture. Shell shock is the best description for her face. My cousin has been together with his wife for 14 years and has had a girlfriend for just as long. Neither of them knew about the other. He got caught because of an image on Facebook. His wife's sister posted a family picture which my cousin was in and got recognized by his girlfriend's sister's acquaintance. He got away with that for 14 years. A friend of mine had 2 kids with a guy who worked in oil fields. He worked in 3-month long shifts where he would travel to another state then come home for 3 months then travel again. They were together 7 years, married for 5, when she was doing laundry and found a second cell phone in his pants. Turns out, he had been married for 10 years to another woman who he also had kids with in his work state. She decided to wait it out, filed for annulment on the basis that he was married to someone else, and filed for custody of their kids while he was gone for work. Once she had it all worked out, she called the first wife and told her that not only had he cheated on her, he married someone else, and fathered 2 other kids. The husband angrily drove for 11 hours back to her state to find the house empty. Unfortunately for her, her not husband anymore found her and beat her within an inch of her life, blaming her for the first wife leaving him. She was in the hospital for several months and he is now in prison. An ex-friend of mine from high school is now in the middle of the second divorce. Apparently it's because she cheated on her second husband with her now current boyfriend. This is the second time she's cheated on her husband and I'm curious if she'll marry the current boyfriend and then cheat on him. This woman I know is dating a very shady guy. She's nearly 40 and desperate, so she overlooks a lot of the red flags. Comma, all her friends think he's an asshole. Comma, he claims he disappears every now and then because, get this, he works for WikiLeaks. Comma, he is married to someone. He claims that they got married only for visa purposes and they only like a few times. He has citizenship now, but they aren't divorced because of some paperwork stuff. Involving, you guessed it, WikiLeaks. Comma, he vacillates between having her attend his family events and declaring that he doesn't believe in marriage and kids. Though, of course, he's married already. He recently suggested they be in an open relationship. She has always wanted marriage and kids, so it surprised me she got on board this relatively easily. I suspect it's because she wants to hold on to him. One of my sister's friends from her sorority had a mental breakdown on her two roommates. Of all the crazy I overheard, the best part was when she got in her car and proceeded to ram into the back of one of the other friend's car, over and over, for almost 2 hours. Like, the god security camera footage of her ramming the car, backing up, and doing it again for 2 whole hours. Amazing. Friend is getting married next weekend. They've been together a few years and have a 2-year-old son. At his bachelor party, we were all poking fun at him on whether or not he was ready. S-faced or sober, he is 100% committed to them. Another friend of mine is close friends with the bride, who is apparently questioning everything about their relationship, and has repeatedly stated that he's not the type of guy she ever imagined seeing herself with. Just found out that my brother, who divorced his ex-wife a year ago, got married to a new woman in secret. I mean secret as in that he hasn't told his own kids about it, 10 and 12 years old. He hasn't told us either, rest of the family. My mother just accidentally said it to all of us. So now we know but are to pretend we don't know. None of us have met his new wife that we don't know is his wife but still know is his wife. Local celebrity who is known for loads of charity work recently attempted to fake his death in America because he has 24 counts of R against him back home. Was a little bit of a surprise. Edit. Here's the story from a link someone posted below. It's American news, but it's been the talk of the town over here. Apparently for years my parents have told my teachers I have a learning disability. I didn't know I had learning disability. I don't think I have a learning disability. I asked them why and they said it takes about $1,500 off the cost of my university tuition from some government grant, so I guess I have a learning disability. Update. I asked my parents more questions about this and I apparently got tested when I was young and have a legitimate learning disability diagnosis. My parents aren't committing fraud. They knew all along that I was diagnosed and I just recently found out about it. My sil is pregnant, again, by the same guy she's been in a two-way abusive relationship with for the past 6 years. Despite constantly moving in and out of his house, filing restraining orders against each other, and accusing each other of cheating every day, they planned this one. Edit. Sil is my husband's sister. Sorry for the confusion. Also, CPS has been to their house. My mil takes the baby off and so she isn't in the house. Not the juiciest, but I have boring life, so a friend of mine doesn't have the best taste in men. She's been talking to this guy that I swear is a pathological liar. She refuses to believe it. She just makes a lot of excuses for him while in the process of continually being disappointed and let down by him. Over the last month, he was supposed to come visit her at least 10 different times. He lives 3 hours away, so it's a long distance relationship. Every time he was supposed to visit, something came up. He was sick twice, then his daughter was sick, then he got ran over, then his mom's dog is dying. All of these are excuses on why he can't come visit. What's fed up is it will be his idea to visit. He will constantly tell my friend he's coming. She will tell him not to worry about it, but he will insist. All for him to give some balls, last minute, excuse on why he can't show up. It seems, to me, like a lot of work to lie like that, but whatever. This recent excuse was the most fed up. This actually happened last night. The guy insisted on coming to see my friend over the weekend. She got her hopes up just for him to call her last minute and say he got into a car wreck. He told her he was at the hospital because he got hurt and his car was totaled, or some s. My friend believed him at first and kept trying to ask him what hospital he was at, but he wouldn't tell her. He even sent her a picture of the car. So my friend messaged another friend of hers telling her what happened. Long story short, the other friend asked my friend to send her the picture and she did some investigating and found an exact picture and article of a wreck that happened in a different state. So the guy lied about being in a wreck. When my friend confronted him about it, he started laughing his ass off and told her it was this elaborate practical joke he was playing on her. Well, she believes him. It's all a big joke and I don't know who to be more pissed off at. The guy for being such a shady character or my friend who is so damn naive. I live by a married man. Him and his family are very close to this lady we'll call Jess. They go on vacations with Jess, but in all photos she is near the husband, not the wife. There have been rumors that the husband is cheating on his wife with Jess. Just rumors though, right? Recently Jess moved across the country. We thought that was the end of it. No. My dad helps people so they can get mortgages, and he just got a call from someone. The husband. They are moving with Jess across the country, teacup without handle. Edit. A lot of people are questioning if it's polyamorous, and I get that it's possible, but I don't know for sure. They could be leaving this conservative neighborhood because that's the situation. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed today's video, drop a like and subscribe. Please check out more of our videos or our playlist. It is perfect for when you want background noise or to put on when you are falling asleep. Once again, thank you and have a great day.